Welcome to the stream, everybody. Today I'm working on native Steam controller support. I'm almost finished with the thing. God! Oh my god. I was running into some crazy problems yesterday with their interface of getting a controller set up. Basically, you gotta go into Steam, put it in big picture mode, go and edit your controller configuration, and it's sticky as hell. So if you get stuck with some settings that are borked, you're fucked. It's like, I spent hours, probably 4 hours yesterday, just trying to get a simple little, like, Steam configuration file working. But after that all got sorted out somehow, luckily, I'm on track to having this code finished. Yeah! What's up, Salad? Ahoy, man! Yeah, it's a bit early today, huh? It's only 3. What's up, Pedro? Stop spamming your Steam. Oh, well, I'm going to have to restart it a lot. So I'm going to check in what I got so far. This is pretty good. So wait, do I need this anymore? I figured out this issue, so I can get rid of that. I don't need this. Oh, I might need this. How you guys doing today? Nice. You buying some lube for your cube? Moving up the cube, huh? What's up, Beach Knee? All's well. Hope all's well with you, too. Just checking in some code here. And then I'll be working on just finishing up the Steam controller. There's only a couple things left to do. Nice. Good here. Okay, let's make sure that still works. Rubik's Lube. What sucks about the Steam controller development is you have to run it from Steam to be able to test anything. Pisses Pedro off. What happened? Son of a bitch. Shit is so buggy. So frustrating to work with this. Oh my god. Last time this happened, I restarted Steam. Actually, I had to restart my entire computer. Alright, Ishii. Let's hope it works. Oh my god, now it works. Steam? Oh my god, I want to punch somebody at Steam that did all the Steam controller code support. It's freaking horrible. Yep, it's gonna be like that for a while until I get this freaking Steam controller settled. Look at that beautiful cat avatar. Who's that? Great person? Who's great person? Okay, so the one little issue I'm running into now is that the buttons are all offset by one. There's like, so it's like the action handle is not quite lining up with the something. I don't know. Let's figure this out. Okay, so we're pushing back action handles right here, and then we're using the action handles here. List what action handle this is. This is pair the first. Okay. So the problem is I press up and he goes left. Press right and he goes up. I press down and he goes right. Press left and he goes down. A does the bombs and it should do the sword. B does the top hat. So it's like all offset by one. There's something in there. So I just printed out all the offsets and everything. Let's see what we got here. We got action handle for A. Handle 5. Code blah blah blah. I know, I don't know what it is. But it'll become apparent, I'm sure. Okay, so this is where we get the handle. Here's where we set the value. Let's only do this set value statement if we have actual data. Same thing. So I think the first thing I pressed was up. Is that right? Shoot, I gotta do it again. I'm going to press just A. Okay, so the action handle for the action for A is handle 5, code 411. Oh my god, it totally worked fine. Oh, maybe it's just bound wrong. Mac Steam controller. What's this tag I'm supposed to be looking for? An input set button down? Set the one. Code is down type. I'm not input component. Okay, so we do need to have some debug here. And player number and button. Oh, it is lookup. Okay, so we need to look up with the map reverse type words int I. Oh yeah, let's try that again. This time I'm just gonna press the A button and I wanna see this debug output. This is what, another thing that sucks about the Steam controller is since you have to launch it from Steam, you can't debug. There's no way for my debugger to attach because I have to actually launch it from Steam. So I'm forced to debug using the good old log statement, the tried and true workhorse of all programmers. Okay, once again, we've got action A, handle 5, code 411. We're setting a value for exactly that same thing. We're calling actual setting button down 411, down 1, type 0, play 0, button B. So it does look like it actually mapped it wrong. Four eleven. What's that? What's that in decimal? Or what, yeah, what's that in decimal? 1041, which means it's index 41. Which would be 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30, 31, 32, 33, 34, 35, 36, 37, 38, 39, 40, 41. Okay, so it's just the wrong freaking button. Okay, so all these bindings are actually correct. Was that right? These bindings are correct. It's button 1A. Right? Seriously. This is such a... I know, right? And they're supposed to, like, if they want their Steam controller to be like popular and for people to use it everywhere, they should make it good for freaking developers to develop for it. You know, right now it sucks so bad to develop for it that, like, I don't want to support this. I don't want any other developer to have to go through this pain. God. That's probably why they have such good support for legacy controllers. Right, yeah, and as a consumer, you can love the Steam controller, right? But this is why so many games don't support it. Natively, at least. So it is giving me code 41, which is button 2. Guess I just need to look at my array or my map. Yeah, you love it too? Yeah. Gosh, I mean, and all they need to do is just make it a little easier. For starters, make it so you can actually launch it from your own game and use a debugger. Separate the API from Steam. Yes, exactly. Make the API be able to be used outside of Steam. Totally. Wasn't it supposed to work out of the box as is? Well, yes, you can. Totally. You can use it out of the box as is. As a consumer, you can go and map your controls to any game. You should be able to. But as a developer, it's really hard to support it. Because of just like all the things I was just mentioning, like how you have to launch it from the Steam client. Yeah, it's native support. Yeah, Raid, no, totally. There's already all support for all other controllers. Now, this is the last controller. So we've already got support for PlayStation controllers, Xbox controllers, Xbox One, Xbox 360. Old school controllers like NES style, USB controllers, every kind of controller you can imagine is already supported, except for Steam, because Steam has this crazy thing where they've got this whole native API. You have to freaking reprogram your stuff if you want to use their native API for the Steam controller. It's just all kinds of lame from a developer's perspective. All right, so I'm gonna look at this map. Saturn controller? What's that? Oh, Sega Saturn? As long as it's USB and it has a normal, it appears to the system as a normal joystick slash gamepad, then yes. It supports all game pads and all joysticks. Yeah, this the only exception there is the Steam controller because the Steam controller has the special API. If you want to use it natively. Like I'm saying, it's weird, man. They have like you can use the game pad as if it were you can use the Steam controller as if it were a regular game pad or regular controller, but that's not supporting it natively. So I'm not sure if haptic feed or the haptic controls work and all that when you do try and do it natively or when you're trying to do it not natively. It's confusing. I'm confused. I'm confused myself. I've been programming this for 2 days now. Still confused. Yeah, bust out the Gravis. Oh. Oh, I totally get it now. Okay, I forgot to match up my Steam mappings to this controller actions. No worries. Okay, so up is going to be axis one positive. And down is going to be 1 negative. What's the difference between the native and the out of the box? Okay, I don't actually know for sure because I haven't been able to test it because of other problems that you have when you try and bind their controls and stuff like that in the Steam client. But I think what would happen is you wouldn't be able to use the haptic. Tell me if I'm right about that, Salad. Can you, when if you're using the Steam controller as a non-native, like the old gamepad style, like emulating X input or whatever, is it able to use the haptic? Exactly, Raid. Yeah, that's what I was thinking too. I don't know if it's true or not though. Like maybe you can actually use the haptic D-pad thing. I forgot that it could control your whole OS. Okay, so it does tra it translate Rumble. That's awesome. Yeah. So what about the D-pad though? Can you use this? Can you use this like as a X input? Axis or something? So left is going to be axis 2 neg. Right is 2 positive. And okay, so A through select start is all going to be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Yeah. Five, six, and this is select is 7. Yep. And start. So this should just work now. Oh, that's cool. Okay, so this is so funny. As a developer, there's pretty much no incentive for me to support the native Steam controller. What's the point? If it can emulate X input, what did I just do the last 2 days? I think there's one tiny advantage in that Valve promotes games that support the native Steam controller. So there's that. Okay, let's see if this works now. Yes! Oh yeah. Down's not working though. Why is down not working? Left and right and up are working. Sweet, the sword. Yeah. Bombs, good. Cactus. Top hat. Lighter. All three of these buttons are the lighter. All these are the blink. All right, select. Yes, we got the menu, start. Okay, so I messed up something with the down button. When I press down, he goes right. So let's figure that out. Oh, I did two, X's two. Oh, how am I supposed to pronounce it? Let's try that again. Oh, is there some mode I can set myself into on Steam where I wouldn't be announcing to everyone that? Can I just go offline? If I go offline, does that mean that people will see when I'm in the game? I think that turns me off, right? So I just press play. People aren't gonna be like, "Oh, he's playing Songbringer again and again." Gosh, that's such a good question, TJ. Pedro's like, yes, thank you, finally. Oh, what did I do wrong that time? Damn it. Damn it. Oh, not one pause. So down is one negative. Tell me, what is this? How many times do I gotta do this? One neg. One pause, one neg, two pause. Yeah, exactly. Yep. And then when you're a developer, you have to support not only buttons, but actions as well. Because you got to support old school gamepads. Well, all gamepads except for the Steam controller and the Steam controller, which works totally differently. Yay. But I'm just griping. I'm griping so much, man. Jeez, somebody slapped me in the face. I'm like a gripey gripestein today. I know. What is the difference? CJ, it's such a good question. What is the difference? What is the point? Oh, you know what? Can you do... Oh, it already emulates Rumble. So what the hell do you need the haptic feedback for? Oh, that's weird. Damn it, the haptic feedback's... this was working yesterday. I'm trying to use the I'm trying to use the haptic D-pad just by barely touching it without pressing the button or anything. It's doing some weird stuff. Looks like it's doing access to... Oh, maybe it's turning it on and off. Okay, let's just make sure everything else is still working. Yeah. Okay, so what's up with that? Whole haptic D-pad thing. Everything's working except for that. Oh. The first part is pronounced like you'd say the letter I, but with an R in front. Oh, ride. And the second part is like the name of the letter O with a D. Oh, like Rido? Rido? Is that right? So let's see what was happening with those values when I was pressing. See this. Righto. Nice. Righto. Best interest in limiting friction. And I'm wondering if it's this. So this way I was setting values a little bit differently. This is a different way to set the values. Let's see if that makes the haptic or the the D-pad. What do you call that? The haptic D-pad? I don't know what you call that thing on the Steam controller. Yeah, I know. If it might be having trouble because the existing, it's using axes instead of buttons. Let's check that out. Another advantage to native is that it gives more devs more fine-grained control over the haptics. Yeah, I guess we could do that. What's up, Code Chef? Welcome, man. Yeah, Code Chef, you're seeing this game run at 15 frames a second because of the limitations of streaming. But yeah, it looks better at 60. Okay, I'm gonna try changing the default bindings and everything for the buttons or for the D-pad directions and all that. So I'm gonna use button 9, 10, 11, and 12. Whoops. Nine, 10. 11, 12. Okay, and then get these mapped as well. And delete my existing bindings. Adding native Steam will be the ability for the Steam controller specific button prompts and icons. Yeah. That is pretty important. Okay, let's see if that worked. Oh yeah, I guess there is that. On the Steam page, you can officially say, yeah, this game supports Steam controllers. Good point. That is kind of a selling point, right? Okay, cool. Oh no, that didn't help. What's up with that feedback? I could have to. I might have to try and play with the Steam settings again. Oh, I don't want to play with the Steam settings again. Oh, righto. Yeah. When you have to like. Yeah. That happens whenever you're using like DS for Windows or whatever, and it emulates like a 360 controller. I know what you mean. And you don't get like the buttons on screen. That's one thing we should check here in a second. I'll do that. Actually, let's do that right now. We can keep these buttons the way they are. Yeah, let's just check this in. Oh, let's put the player somewhere where we can get an item. Like, negative 50? I don't know. Oh, yeah. Yeah, totally. Okay, let's see if that if I use the Steam controller to get that. Oh shit. Gotta launch it from Steam again. Ah. Oh, okay, so the input controller type's not working. It's still showing me keyboard. And it's still showing me keyboard input on the bottom there. Right. Well, okay, so what I want to happen here is I've already got the icons drawn for the Steam controller. Why is that taking forever? So here's the Steam icons in beautiful pixel art. So I just got to get those to show up on the bottom of the screen and stuff. So why are they not? That's a good question. Oh, maybe it's some call to set input controller type. What is it again? First, let's call this. So the set value function sets the press values or release values, says last values. But where does it actually set the input? Somewhere where it's, oh, it's like set button down. Set button down. There it is. I thought it. Code down type, there it is. What's type? It's right here in set type. Okay, so input types, paired out first, shifted down 16. Input types. Oh, thanks, Salad. Appreciate it, man. What's up, T? What up, man? Did you get that code working yesterday? So I must not have set input types. And that's really easy to do. I just want to see where I do that for the other ones. Input types device hash. This is right when you set up the controller. Okay. So, same thing for setting up a Steam controller. We've got the prefixes and the input type. Okay, so we got a device hash, base code. We get the prefix. We set the prefix. We also set the input type. Oh, you didn't? Well, it's good to take a day off, huh? Just play. Wish I could. I wish I had more time to just take time off and play. I got so many games to play. I got Owlboy I just started, which is really good. I got Cave Story to try out. Volgar the Viking. Yay! Okay, those look crappy though. Damn it. We're really gonna have to play with the graphics for these. Probably. Whoops. What? Oh. Yeah, those look horrible. Okay, well, let's work on the graphics for him. You can make games or play games, but not both? Yeah, I can't wait to try it. I haven't even started it. I started Owlboy because I was really excited for Owlboy. Okay, so here's Steam's icons as they're supposed to look. And to get these to look better in pixel art, gosh, maybe I'll get rid of the blue outline. I don't know. We'll try this out. Let's try. I'll change the A and try and make it look a little better with the blue outline. Let's see. Maybe we can salvage this and make it look cool, but maybe not. It's a lesson in determination? Yeah? Why is that? It's, well, I guess I can, from my own perspective, it's kind of has been so far, because like, I don't really enjoy playing really heavily story-driven games that much these days. I really prefer a lot of combat and action, and it's a pretty heavily story-based game. Oh, you mean it's development? Oh, I was considering it from my own selfish perspective. Shame on me. Coach Jeff, oh my god, you bring up a really excellent point. You've always wanted to make a game, but you feel like you'd get bored of playing it before you could finish it. That is a serious problem. It really is. And, you know, I've been making this game, Songbringer, for 2 years now, and I would say that it's happened to me already. You know, you get, like, there's times where you've played your own game so much that you do get bored of it. And my recommendation is, if you're the kind of person that wants to make these long-term, huge game projects, that you take a break from actually playing your game and let other people play it. So I ran into that like 6 months ago or whatever. I was just like, I have been playing Songbringer every single week for like, I would do at least like a 2 hour play session with it. And it got old. I was like, man, I've already played this game so many times and only tiny little things have changed each week. So that's when I finally decided like, I really do have to take a break from this and let other people play it. Let other people give me their feedback. And rather than myself, only trusting my own self to like to get my own feedback. So. Yeah, pushing past on Wii. But that really helped me. And then now that the game has matured a little bit, 6 months later, there's a lot of stuff that's changed, so I enjoy playing it again. And then there's going to be even more stuff that changes over the next few months, so that'll help out too. So that's, I don't know. It's a good thing to bring up though, man. It really is an issue. And you have to think about how you're going to handle that. All right, let's try it again. Okay, so this time it's going to, the A button is going to be have a nice clean outline, and we'll see if that looks good or if, oh yeah, it totally does. Oh, sweet. Okay, so I get to change all the buttons to have a nice clean outline like that. All right, let's do this. Pixel art, man. Pixel art really, really benefits from clean outlines, clean things, rather than things looking too dirty and messy and realistic. I'm not even hooking up my graphics tablet because this is just such a quick bit of art to do. Yeah, and then if you're the kind of person that can do smaller games, then definitely do smaller games. Like game jams. Game jams are a great way to get into like making games because you're making a short game. It's only like 48 hours that you work on it. Oh, you've done system development and web development already. Okay. Yeah. Yeah, Teek. Yeah, Teek's has done several different of the Ludum Dares, and he's got a game released on Steam. Brawls McDonald! Duh! What's up, Mr. Frenick? What's up, man? How you doing today, Frenick? What's the news, man? Give me the news! You working on your material system? Sweet, man. Physically based materials. Working with pixel art? What do you mean? I'm working on the Steam controller today still. So thankfully I'm through the hard parts and finishing up the Steam controller now. I'll be doing Rumble today. So just, it's not really Rumble. It's like more like emulating Rumble. And trying to fix the bug, whatever bug there is with the haptic D-pad thing. Bro McDonald had a farm. Bro, 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 bro. Ah, physically based lighting. Small games for old consoles? Sweet. Oh man. Oh, that sucks when there's for old consoles where like nobody back then it was hard to spread your game. I know what you mean. I used to make games for DOS and we were just starting to get bulletin boards and things like that, but it was the same kind of concept. It's not like all your friends it's not like everybody in the world could play your games. Okay, so that should look better. Oh, good. Those look a lot cleaner now. So does that. Why use equipment map? I think it could go a little darker on the bottom, though. Nah, it's good enough. I like it, checking it in. Whoa, the NES, the Master System? What? Thank you, Amarok. I appreciate you saying that, man. Appreciate it a lot. Thanks a lot. Okay, so I can go and I'm going to check in what I've done so far. We got Steam controllers working for the most part. This is really great progress compared to what I thought it would be like. Let's check in the HUD first. So for the NES, was that all? Did you use all assembly for that? So all it changed was input controllers, input system. Oh, input system. We don't need that. Cool, so all we changed was input controllers. I changed the default bindings. Maybe I'll change those again to keep them in order. No, don't need to do that. Assembler for all three, whoa. That's awesome, man, I got respect for that. I know like the basics of assembler, but I've never actually coded anything in assembler. I think like maybe I've coded like one small inline assembled function back in like the 1990s, but nothing at all like an actual project. All right, I can comment out that got action handle. Oh, there it is. And what else? Oh, this if data, oops. Okay, I think that should be all. Right, I just changed the default bindings and I changed the way I added the input type. That was it, really. All right. Now there's only a couple things left to do. The rumble, or emulating rumble with the haptic feedback, and figuring out what's wrong with the haptic input thing. I'm loath to try and go and change my settings. You found it easier than using C# with Unity? Whoa. And C++ with Unreal? It's just simpler or something. Oh, was assembly your first language, or like one of your first languages? All right, there's a function in let's just look it up here. Source Steam, iSteam controller. There it is, iSteam controller. There's a function here in iSteam controller. Here it is, trigger haptic pulse or trigger haptic repeated haptic pulse. E Steam controller pad? What the hell is that? Oh, I guess it's either the left or the right, like the left pad or the right pad. And then duration in microseconds. I think that the max you can do there is pretty short, like a 30th of a second or something, a 60th. Okay, so I'm not going to use repeated haptic pulse. I'm going to trigger a haptic pulse. So I've got the controller handle. Can get the target pad and the microseconds. Okay, I think I got what I need here. Oh, okay. Oh, wow. So you kind of did start with assembly. Okay, so I gotta move the Steam controllers out to well, if I'm gonna do Rumble, let's go look at the Rumble class again. Okay, so the Rumble class works by taking a player type. And then it gets a device hash. Uh, Oh, it gets a device hash just by looking at the FF array. And then when it ticks the rumble effects, it just goes and takes the device hash. And it calls rumble get device, so it gets an auto f a force variable. So, okay, I guess the best way I could do this to make it keep it simple is I could emulate or I could subclass whatever the hell force is. This rumble get device, what does this return again? A force feedback pointer. So yeah, I'll subclass force feedback pointer to get a Steam controller force feedback. And then I guess I'll need to implement the default functions and stuff like that. But it shouldn't be too hard. That way I can actually push back a force feedback device for each one of the Steam controllers. And that way I won't have to rewrite my Rumble code. We'll need to implement supports effect and get force type. And we'll need to push back. Okay, so yeah, let's do this. I'm gonna subclass force feedback. So I'm gonna call this Steam controller force feedback. Class force feedback Steam public force feedback. Missed much? You missed a little. Not that much, though. It's kind of hard to get that much done in just an hour, you know? Okay, so the force feedback class, what do I have to implement here? Public interface, which means what? What do I have to implement there? No, not that interface. Wrong interface. C tags. C tags is not all that great. I mean, it's pretty good, but when you have things that are named the same thing, you just don't even know what you're gonna get. One little thing about C tags and Vim. So I need set master gain, set auto center mode, upload, modify, remove, get FF axes number. All right, let's just copy all these. So the force feedback Steam will need to take a controller handle. Controller handle type. I'll be right back. Get some water. See you, righto. The Bro McDonald song. Bro McDonald had a farm. Bro, 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 bro. And on that farm, he had a chicken. Bro, 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 bro. How's the rest of old McDonald go? Oh, E-I-E-I, bro. Yeah. All right, we got things set up, sort of. Oh, force feedback steam. Yeah, it did. Nice. CMake policies. Oh, I don't even know what those did. Some of those. Oh, yeah. Now I'm starting to remember what those were. Yeah. CMake policies, right? Yeah. Some of those things you're like, man, it would really help if I knew that. We when you first get started and all that? So I'm implementing a subclass of OIS's force feedback to basically use it to do quasi rumble for the Steam controller. Just going to use Steam one this single function in Steam controller. But since I've already written this whole all this code to do rumble, I will kind of want it to do this do it the same way. So I'm just subclassing. Is there a line that says include platform? Oh, platform. Yeah, let me show you what that is. It's in projects, Linux. It's an include platform.cmake. Here it is. I got this from Cocos 2DX. So Cocos 2DX has this for their Linux build or whatever. And platform.cmake. Oh, it's kind of long. I'll post this on oh, it's not that long. Basically what it does is this. It just runs some ifs and stuff to determine what platform you're on. So like right, see if it's like matches Windows. I'll put this online too on the gist. But yeah, I totally stole this from Cocos 2DX. Oh, you already do that? Oh, okay. Do you want me to post this? Okay, I'll do it. Got it. Yeah, and then Cotire or Cotire, I don't know how to say that, but it's got its own little CMake file you can use as well. And but you can get all that from Cotire. How do you say that? Does anybody know how to pronounce this? What language is it? So we'll need a handle. I guess we could use a master level, master gain. Nice. I'm glad you found that. It's faster now, but ignores walls. Oh, you got it, man. You can get it working. The way it works is it custom generates a Unity build. Yeah, and you're already using Unity. Well, it also does pre-compiled headers. That's the one I'm using it for. So you can turn off the Unity build part, which I do. I think I actually do that in that in the CMake file you see there. It turns off Unity because I can't really use Unity builds. Whoa, 32 bytes per tile in RAM. That's pretty significant. That's what I that's the thing I found for PCHs on Linux. And it works pretty well for that. Really sped up the Linux builds, that's for sure. So we want to push back what kinds of add effect types. eForce. We want to just do constant. Yeah, just constant. Effect constant force and effect constant then whenever we upload or modify, we're not even, we're going to ignore remove, but all this does, so we'll call modify. Or upload, call upload from modify. So this upload effects and this one we're gonna say if Steam controller equals null return otherwise. What is it called? Trigger haptic pulse? Yeah. Trigger haptic pulse. The controller handle is our handle variable. The E Steam controller pad. I don't know what that is. See if we can jump to it. Oh yeah, you can jump to it now. All of a sudden, your build is less than 5 seconds. That's so great. Oh yeah. Yeah. You'll get your build time down from 5 to like 3 seconds. You'll be like, oh, God, that's so awesome, Salad. 5 seconds. Okay, we got K Steam E controller pad left or right. Let's just start with the left pad. See how that, see how that goes. US duration in microseconds. We want to do K seconds per tick. This is microseconds. This is seconds. So we want to go micro times 1,000 times 1,000. There anything else? Is that it? Error. What's error? Oh, no error. Sweet. Does that compile? Yes, I know, right? I'm still getting used to Vim, and sometimes I forget I'm in insert mode. I'm all, whoops, forgot to press escape again. All right, so now we need to create a bunch of these Steam force feedback. Things. Whenever we create a Steam controller. Wait, what's FF? FF. It's like this, it's a vector of. There it is. It's a vector of UN16 is the device hash to force feedback pointer. Okay. Okay, I got it. We're going to create a new force feedback pointer, push it back into this force feedback array for the Steam controller. And when the controller's object destructs itself, it will go and delete any of force feedback pointers that are Steam controllers. And when it creates one, that's where I'll actually create the Steam controller. So I think we want to go to init Steam controllers. Set up Steam controllers. Here we go. So here. Create force feedback. Auto force it equals ff.find device hash. If force it. Actually, let's do this simpler. If not contains ff device hash. This should be possible. Yeah, good, good. Oh, this is pretty easy though. So we'll go ff device hash equals new force feedback steam given handles I. And no compiler errors. Sweet. Okay, now when we're destructing this whole object, we want to go clean out any force feedback. Oh, we could do it in shutdown Steam controllers. So for auto ref pair in FF, auto force equals dynamic cast force feedback steam pointer given pair.second if force frost. If the force is not equal to null, use the force, man. Delete force. There, so that'll automatically clean up force feedbacks. There you go. H. Steam force feedback. Okay. I wish I could freaking use the debugger here, but since I can't, I'll just hope this works. yeah. Just gonna hope this works. I got nothing. It works and it's faster now. Yeah, Teak. High five, man. Right on. Yeah. The moment of triumph has arrived for you. You're Mr. Magic. That's right, Mr. Magic. Mr. Magic, pull a rabbit out of your hat. You can do anything. Okay, I need to, like, get hurt so I can trigger some force feedback. It works. It's like going. It's such a weak little like rumble, fake rumble. It's such a cute little rumble. And you made your light system moddable? Sweet, man. You're kicking ass. I'm honestly really surprised that worked. Make it play jib sound effects through the haptics? Okay, but it's not using the, it's only using the left controller pad, so let's start with the right controller pad too. I want to go jump to force feed back steam. And since there's no gain value, you can't give it a gain value, you only give it the duration that it's going to pulse for. So I can get rid of this master gain. That's not needed. And I'll give it one Boolean variable. It's like left or right. Oh, yeah. Mr. Magic. So we'll just say bool left. Bool left is false. And we'll say left equals not left. And this is, we'll go auto pad equals left. We do the E Steam controller left. Oh, I'm cheating. I'm using my mouse. Or right. And then this will just be pad. What's up, RuneWord? It's going really good today. I'm working on the Steam controller more, and I almost got it all done. Let's check this out. See if this feedback now works for it. It should go left, right, left, right, left, right, left, right. So I'm emulating Rumble by using this haptic feedback thing. So it should go and like basically emulate Rumble with the Steam controller, even though it doesn't have Rumble. Using the, I know, right? I was such a bad person. I was using Vim so well today, and then I used my mouse for a second. Okay, I just need to get hurt by some enemies. Yeah, it's doing left, right. Wait, I'm not even getting hurt anymore. I'm still getting the haptic feedback. That's really weird. What's with that? Okay, I'm just gonna get hurt once. Oh, okay. It did work once. Is it jib? What? It's like getting stuck somehow. It's like playing the rumble or the haptic feedback thing over and over and over. But sometimes it's not. Like it gets stuck and then it doesn't. All right, let me check it out. So the unfortunate thing about this RuneWord is that I can't debug. I can't use debugger tools to debug the Steam controller because you have to launch it from Steam. So I would just freaking debug this, but since I can't, I'm gonna try and use some old school tricks. NMs, debug alert. All right, so if we go, if it's left, we'll say we haptic left, haptic right. Oh, you can attach to a running process, that's right. I could do that. I could do that. Then I'd be old school GDB, and I'd have to like do GDB style stuff, which is just not kind of a hassle. I would love to be able to attach to it with Xcode, you know, because this Xcode is just, I don't know, I'm more efficient debugging with Xcode than I am with GDB. I can debug with GDB, but I find it kind of like, I don't know, kind of difficult. So I'll do this. I'm just gonna say debug haptic left or haptic right whenever it's doing this and figure out why it's doing this whole thing, whether it's my code or whether it's Steam's code. Yeah, it is pretty good. Visual Studios is also really nice. I like Visual Studios debugger. It's actually really great about how it shows you values and stuff for things. I love Visual Studios, it's pretty cool. Yeah, the watch variables. Oh, you're talking about watching variables? Yeah. Its auto variables are good too. Being the detective in a crime movie where you're also the murderer. Oh. I never thought of it that way. Okay, it works. It might be, the problem might be that it's doubling up, like it's doing two effects at once and then it somehow gets stuck. Yeah. Now it's just going left, right, left, right. Somehow getting stuck. See, here we are, just triggering haptic feedback left and right. It's almost like it didn't remove the effect. Oh no! It's just because I have low health! Oh, check it out, if I go give myself some health. Oh, it was fine. It was fine the whole time. I'm like, it's stuck. But no, it was just because it was low health. So it was trying to show me that you're on low health by... Oh, I get it. It was working. GDB with TUI? What? What's that? Oh, I'm invincible now. Yeah, dude, this is sweet. I got almost everything working for the Steam controller. There's one thing left to do. Let me check this out. This GDB with TUI? I've never heard of that. Azimuth, what's up, man? Low HP drive me insane if I can't find HP in games. What are you saying, man? Okay, I want to see some images for GDB TUI mode. Oh, is this it? Oh, wow, it actually shows you your source code like that? Oh, what's up, man? Oh, it beeps in time with the music. That's something I should do. It's not hard at all. Oh man, that's so easy. I'm gonna add this to my list. Because I already know the tempo of every song because I set that in the data. So it's super easy once you got the tempo. What's up, Somber Taco? Oh, they drive you insane if you can't find the HP. An option. So wait, Azenris, tell me something. Would you prefer to have an option that would disable the sound effect for that? Okay, so I can get rid of that. Yes. All right, Steam controller rumble done. Steam controller rumble. You wouldn't mind it. All right. Okay. I'll add that. You don't like the low beeping either? What about, okay, what about the red things on the side of the screen and the rumble? Both of those things. What if your controller's rumbling? And also, what if there's red things on the side of the screens? So if I add this option, should it disable all that stuff? Or should it keep the red things and the rumble and just not play the sound? Tell me your preference there. Just a sound effect for you. An option enables, they will beep three times and then stop beeping. But the red stays. Ah. Okay. Gotcha. Okay. Okay, so I just implemented a little, I subclassed force feedback, OIS's force feedback class, and implemented a very simple thing for like a Steam emulation of force feedback. Triggers haptic pulses. You can actually make music. Salad was saying earlier there about like make it play jib sound effects. You can actually kind of make it sound like music if you really, really play with it enough. But I don't have time for that. So this cleans up the force feedback when you're shutting down the controllers. It goes and loops through. It goes, if it's a force feedback Steam, delete it. Nice GIF, right on. contains FF device ash, device ash. Yeah, cool. Oh, dude, that looks sweet. That model looks really cool too. Super dope, man. Yeah. It's freaking awesome. Steam controller sings the Doom theme. That's awesome. Wait a minute. This is actually showing, I gotta open this up and I gotta open that up and see that, because I want to see what he's actually doing. All pixel art. Note 40. How is it doing notes? Let's find out. GitLab. What's GitLab? Oh, check it. He's not even using the Steam API. It's a competitor, really. Play note. How is it doing a different note, though? That's what I'm wondering. Oh, yeah. Or you can have their corporate service. An open source Steam controller driver. Oh, man. Keeps on making me think, like, oh, did I have to do all this? But at least it's all done now. Okay, so MIDI frequencies. Okay, these are frequencies for different notes, I'm guessing, for 128 different notes. All right, there's the frequency, but how would he actually trigger it to do a different note? Because from what I just saw, let me check this in before I do anything else. Rumbles in quote marks. Right, right. Yeah. Right, okay, but so how do they translate an actual frequency? Okay, I see what you're saying. What Teeks is saying, the frequency is that, and then the period is 1/ the frequency. Steam controller magic period ratio. What's that? Oh, so this many microseconds. So this is about 49 milliseconds. Wow. Okay, so he plays a note by simply just turning on the haptic feedback for a certain amount of time. So the less time, I'm imagining it probably, it does like, yeah, it must be less time means less of a note. This is crazy. This is a crazy amount of work to do just to get this the Steam controller to sing songs, but it does, you can do it. And here's an example of how. Wow. This is pretty cool. Yeah. If anybody's, you guys can all follow the links in that, but yeah, that's pretty neat. Wow. This is so cool. And what's awesome is that you can learn how to use the Steam controller without the Steam API, if you're so inclined. Wow. What a cool day. This is great to finally be almost finished with the Steam controller. Figuring out what frequency period was necessary to get a specific note. Yeah. And then, like, worked from frequencies after that. Yeah. Wow. That's crazy. That's quite an accomplishment to do that. Okay, there's only one thing left to do. The D-pad is all kind of messed up. And I think we could maybe fix it by going into big picture mode and editing the Steam controller settings. Okay, this makes me nervous because this took me 4 hours yesterday just to get this right. Didn't have to be that hard. But they have a super buggy, super duper buggy interface, and it's so sticky. If you mess up with this, there's no way to unmess it up. Okay, so what am I thinking? Oh, the haptic part? Yeah. This bit, it's acting like a general direction pad, but the advanced settings, it doesn't require a click. It's radial with overlap. Let's try this radial without overlap. That's all. That should be it. Just setting radial without overlap. That means no diagonals? Oh, that'll suck. Let's see if it worked though. To make it not all weird and twitchy. Yes. Is this music too? No way! This is so rad. I gotta appreciate that. Wow. Okay, this time I'm using the haptic. Oh, it's still jittery. Super jittery, but I think it's actually, let's see this in slow-mo. It's like it's actually turning on and off. Yeah, it's turning off button 12 every once in a while. So I wonder if that's actually Steam's API doing that, or is my code messing up? Let's try that again. Hopefully this works by right-clicking on the game like this. Sometimes it doesn't. Oh, see, this doesn't work. You can't change the freaking advanced settings. Ah, God. The final countdown. Okay, this time we're gonna change it so you actually have to click the D-pad. I just wanna see if it works. Cause I think I wanna keep it so it has the haptic. But let's see what it feels like and if it works with just the having to click it. Requires click on. We'll do radial with overlap. There's also cross gate, a cross shaped pad layout that prioritizes horizontal and vertical movement over the diagonals. That sounds good, but let's keep it back with radial with overlap because we got the requires click on. There's also a dead zone. Not exit Steam, damn it. Let's hope Steam works this time when I launch it. Bugginess. Sometimes when I launch Steam, the Steam controller doesn't even recognize. Okay, does it work? Yes, it works. Oh, what? I turned it to click, and this time it's still doing the haptic. Guess we'll try editing it again. You never know whether it worked. With this whole Steam. I find Steam to be a little bit better on Windows, but it's still buggy. As far as this whole configuration of controllers. It requires click on. Radial with overlap. Did you just ignore what I just did? God. Okay, so before I go run Songbringer, let's do that again and see if it even saved. This is why it took me 4 hours just to get a freaking setup, an initial controller configuration. Oh man, the pain of yesterday is coming back to me. Yes, requires click on, thank you. Radial with overlap. It remembered this time. Exit big picture. Right. Shadow mapping. Yeah, all right. Okay. Oh my God, it's still broken. Even though I click it, I'm like clicking the haptic feedback thing. And it's still all jittery as hell. It's like, okay. So that means it's probably has to, it's either my code or it's the way Steam's code works with it. Okay, and since I can't debug, let's figure out the best solution here to try and catch this issue. I think I've already got a log statement. It must be commented out though. It's in. Said button down or something. Okay, so this says setting value percent %d. Okay. But I also want to see when it actually sets a value. Okay, that should be enough. Later, Teague. See you, man. Okay, so I'm just pressing the right. Let's see what kind of data we get here. So we've got setting value 1, action handle 4. Setting value 1. But then it says it to 0. Okay, let's do that again to so get some more data. Cool, Barney, what's up, man? Pressing just right. Give me some weird data, it looks like. Setting value 0000. Oh, we only want to see action handle. Handle 5, I think. Handle 4, handle 4. Or if code is 41B. Oh, what's up, man? Good night. Good night, Kobarney. So if action pair dot second and input k code mask. Equals that. Oh, that's a warning. Yes. Oh, I love this. God, you complete me to be a little bit better this morning by doing all its options right. Getting rid of its errors and stuff too. Okay, I hope that works. So I can see what's going on. I think it's actually returning zero every once in a while. Which means that... what can I do? If the Steam API is actually returning a zero value, that means that I need to consider that it released the button. So it's like my code's doing it right. Hopefully, maybe there's just something wrong. Okay, good. I did the right debug statement. Yeah, it's definitely setting zero periodically. It's like setting value one. And then it gets a zero, even though I didn't ever let go of the button. Is this a bug in the Steam controller API? Wait a minute. What's this? What's data handles? Digital action data. Will be true if it's currently pressed. Oh, maybe it's not active. Okay, might as well set the current active or the current action set. Possibility. Might need to set the current action set handle every time it pulls the controllers. Hopefully. We'll see if that works. Oh, it's supposed to be offline. Wasn't it? It's also print out whether it's active or not. And I guess we can call Steam Controller run frame, just have the latest updated data. Shoot, what is this? The Steam Controller is returning, like, I hold down a button on the haptic feedback, and it says, it comes back as one, it's held down. And then, even though I'm holding it down the entire time, the Steam API keeps throwing me zeros every once in a while. What the hell's with that? Especially happens when you're going diagonal. None of that helps either. Well, last thing to try is the, I guess try that cross input type. Hey Sal, are you still there? I got a question for you. I'm wondering if there's any way to overwrite a controller config or to start a brand new controller config. Yeah, do you know of any way to start a brand new controller config? Like, I have not found this. It would be so helpful if I could just erase all this and start completely new. Yeah, see, but when I start with the preset, the problem is this. When you load a preset, let me show you what I mean. When you load a preset, you get stuff like this. Reset to default, that just resets the current button. Yeah. Here's one of them. So here's the problem. It gives you, is this the one? No. Is this the one? Let me show you my actual controller configuration right now. That's a good one too. Yeah, I know, right, Ezra's? Here. Where is it again? Oh, library, application support. Create a blank config file. I think, okay, this is also the thing. I have no idea, like, I was trying to do this last night by erasing my controller config, but it's just like, it's so sticky that it doesn't allow you to change this file on your hard drive. It somehow stores it in memory or stores it in the cloud. Yeah, see, that's what I was saying, Azenris. You can't delete the file. If you delete the file, it puts the file right back. If you overwrite the file with something else, it goes and still overwrites it. It's like impossible to change, right? I don't know what to do. This is like 4 hours of frustration yesterday. Here's what it looks like. Controller configs apps 3670F. Both of these, or no, let's go to the guest one. It's the same exact thing, guest or that one. Here's the actual controller config file. Should mod it to be read only? That's an interesting thought. That might work. Here it is. Okay, here's what I'm talking about. So this is what happens when you start a configuration with one of their templates. It still has these unused things. And I'm wondering if this is what's giving me these zero values right now. Like, it's just, you know, I hold down the one button, but sometimes it returns zero even though I'm holding it down. I'm thinking it might be because it's trying to process some of its input as X input. So at the bottom of this file, right here, these are the game actions that I've bound actually to native Steam controls, right? And this is a group of those controls. But up here, like I was just showing you, it's still got bindings for X input because I started with that template for X input. And I was trying for hours last night to try and just get rid of this freaking group. That's all I wanted to do, is just delete this group, start with a brand new file. But let's go back in there. Maybe I'm missing something. I guess I could maybe try making it read only. Hold on. Let's try that. Let's go. Let's go into the library. Start editing the controller. Go back out. Our Steam controller? I'll get that open. All right, this is great. I didn't know there was one of these. They have. Oh my god. Oh, sweet. That would be really nice to know. Let's see if this works though. Okay, I think this one called dash good is the right one, or maybe this one. Game action. Yeah. Default title. What's this good one? Oh, here it is. Good, yeah. So this one has my library called library save wizard foo. And it doesn't have those X inputs. And it's got this stuff cleaned up at the bottom. Okay, so this is the one I want to use. Well, no. See, the thing is, if I close, wait, maybe it would work if I close Steam if it's read only. Huh, that's a good question. Let's try that. So last night I was trying it on Windows and it would overwrite it. What the hell is this? It would overwrite the file every time I restarted. What's up, Righto? Okay, so let's overwrite these. With this. And then let's make him read only. Oh, does it? Okay. Okay, they're both read only now. What's up, Rocket? up, buddy? Let's just confirm that. Yeah, just read. Okay, it's just readable. Yeah, Righto, this is gonna be on Steam. You can pre-order it right now and get your own. You can get to be part of the private beta, or you can just wait till it comes out on Steam. Okay, so let's see if that worked. I'm gonna go into big picture mode. Controller config, and it should have the haptic feedback or these things set to. Oh, it didn't work, see? This is the thing that I don't understand. Like, how does it freaking do this? I overwrote the file, but it didn't load that. Maybe I can actually browse my config and load a personal local config. No. That didn't work. Nice, H&E, right on. What if I do, Oh, wait. Oh. Now it's okay? Holy crap, it might have worked now. So let's try exporting the. Oh, and this, I want to do these. This might have worked. And then I'll try exporting it, saving a new local only binding file. What's up, Grizz Grass? All right, let's hope that worked. Oh my God, I hope it did. If this worked, oh, if this worked. All right, so we want to, first of all, look at these files. Oh. Is it still read only? It's still read only. Yeah, Grizzgrass, thank you, man. Oh, it's such a big compliment. It better be better than Titan Souls. That's for sure. And it's, saying it's better than Hyper Light Drifter is a maybe thing. I hope so. I think people will see that the gameplay is, I don't know. You could say that in some senses the Songbringer gameplay is a little more varied and deep because you got a lot more items. But like, the art, I don't think the art for Songbringer will be as good as Hyper Light Drifter's. Hyper Light Drifter's art is sick. It's so good. Yeah, Hyper Light was incredible. It was. But I personally thought the gameplay of Hyper Light Drifter got boring. It's just the same thing over and over and over. And you get to start with the items, you know, you already have the ability to dash and do all this stuff. You already have your sword at the beginning. You get the whole map. There's a lot of things about Hyper Light's gameplay that I was like, what? Why'd they do it like that? Okay, I don't know how to read whether this file got written correctly. Did it? It didn't save any new files. Or did it? It doesn't look like it saved anything new there. Oh, and the procedural. That's right. I forgot about the procedural part. Yeah, that's another big drawback to Hyper Light. If Hyper Light Drifter was procedurally generated, I'd still be playing it. I'd still be creating worlds and stuff. But because it was the same game, I started another adventure and I'm like, it's the same thing. Yeah, it was definitely a great game. It's probably my favorite game of 2016. They finally made it 60 frames a second though. That's cool. I don't know if they ever got it to work on Windows though. Okay, so what I'm gonna try is going back into big picture mode, go back into edit, and see if it still has that controller config, because if it does, that's pretty awesome. I don't know where it's storing that file, but it just suddenly magically worked. Oh, it didn't save it. Okay, wait, but what if I go and turn off this thing being read-only. So I will let it write, and then go back in here, and once again apply these little changes. So this is the item 5L. This is 6R. This thing up is Y. Left is X, right is B, down is A. And this is a click. You have to click it, and it's radial without overlap. Is that it? I think that's all. Okay, so if I export this config now, yeah, the OST also so awesome. Yeah. Oh, even their sound effects. Sound effects are sweet. Okay, let's see what happened. Oh, it modified this one. 5:22 p.m. Let's see if it is what we hope it is. Oh, oh. Okay, game action, game action, game action. I don't see any X input yet. Oh my god, it worked! It freaking worked! We got rid of all that BS extra stuff. How do you burn an image onto an SD card? You could use DDE, but it's tricky. Sudo something? I would definitely use a GUI application. Those are just a lot easier than using sudo DDE. Oh my god. Okay, so did this actually work? Did this fix the problem with the haptic feedback? That's the question. So if I play the game. No, it didn't fix it. But at least the controller config's now clean. So I don't know what I'm running into here, but the actual values I'm getting from Steam's API, when I just press up, I'm actually getting the value up as 1. It'll be like 1111110000110010000. It's just like throwing in these freaking zeros, so it makes the freaking player do this jittery motion. And I tried making it so you have to hold down you have to click the actual haptic feedback, but that didn't work. The only thing I didn't try so far was the cross. I guess we can try the cross. Yeah. If I can't get this to work, then that means I have to disable. I don't know what else to do. I'll have to disable the D-pad in the official config. Really weird. It's really weird, Grizzgrass. Oh, wait. Oh, what if I make it just a button pad? Oh, this could be it. I hope this works. Oh, I hope this works. Okay. One thing I've got to do before I even try it is go back into Steam's big picture mode and make sure it actually set that. A lot of bass coming from some truck outside or something. Because you never know. It ought to. It totally ought to, Salad. But it's not. Oh, either that or I was... Oh, you know what it might have been, Salad? It might have actually been that I was treating it... Because it was a D-pad, or because it was set up here, I had it set up in the controller config as a direction pad. It might have actually been an analog value it was sending back, and I was trying to treat it as a digital value. So that might have been it. Okay, so let's see. It did actually save that. Okay, so now we can run it. And see if the player can actually just move without being all jittery. Oh, yeah. Wait, no? No? No. Still doing it. I'm just holding right. And now I'm just holding left. Ugh. Yeah, Salad. I think that's what I'm gonna try next. Well, that's gonna be it for today's stream. But I will go. The next thing I'll try is I'll try playing around more with those settings, but also trying and treating it as an analog value rather than a digital value, because it's probably what it is. It's probably just a digital value or an analog value. So that should be pretty easy to get fixed if that's it. So. I could round it. If I start treating it as an analog value, I'll treat it above a certain threshold will be considered on. I know the API is not very good, or the documentation is not very good. You should see it. It's like a description, but it doesn't describe anything about the functions. But yeah, I'll figure this out. This is good. Thank you guys for all the help today. Great suggestion, Salad, to try and like just make this read-only. This actually worked. So Salad's suggestion was to make this read-only, and that actually worked. It didn't overwrite its own file, and then I could clean it up. So that's good. So one step closer to having this all finished. Yeah, so see you later, guys. See you later, guys. Have a good evening. It was great talking with you guys today. See y'all next time.